In the recent summer, I visited Finland and Helsinki. While being there, I took a ferry trip to a group of islands a couple of kilometers offshore to Helsinki. The trip alone, going through all the small islands, although windy, was worth it already. However, I took this ferry for a different reason, to visit what they call Suomenlinna. Suomenlinna is a former fortress spread over six islands. It nowadays is more a open sky museum in the park and recreational space, as well as home for around 900 people living there. It also is on the list of UNESCO World Heritage and attracting hundreds of thousands of visitors every year. I didn't know much about it before I went there, to be honest. All I knew was that they had the first built and last remaining Type 2 U-boat there, the Vesico. This submarine was a kind of secret project between Germany that after World War I was not allowed to build submarines anymore but wanted to do so anyway, and Finland that happily agreed to integrate the first ship of a new line of submarines into their own navy. Later in Germany this class was called Type 2 U-boat and 50 more got built, and the very first of its kind is this very submarine. Going inside costs just a couple of euros and one can literally go through in it in some minutes, because it's so small with just 41 meters of length. Also, not all of the boat was accessible as well, which made the trip even shorter. I start the video on the bridge, looking into the radio operator's room. It looks somewhat spacious on the GoPro, but really it was not very tiny space. Right next to it, the bridge with the periscope, access to the tower and all controls. Nothing fancy like in the larger U-boats of the movies or even modern submarines. You could walk right past it and barely even notice. Only wander further down the boat, there is the engine compartment with two six-cylinder diesels from MWM, German producer Motorenwerke Mannheim, each producing 350 horsepower or 257 kilowatts. Impressive machines in good condition, it seems. Right behind the diesel engines is the electrical section with two electric motors of 180 horsepower or 132 kilowatts each, seen at the bottom of the floor. All the voltmeters and such are quite interesting, as many of those have mixed German or Finnish labels on them, like these right here. Filming in there was a bit tricky, not just because it was quite cramped, but also because people were coming from the back and I didn't want it to be too much of an obstacle. Near the rear end, only separated through a curtain, there are four cozy beds, where sailors surely had good dreams not far from the diesel engines. Right where I just left the boat, in former times there was a toilet, the only one. The paint on the outside is not original, the boat was repainted several times in the past already. It's however a menacing look and I was quite impressed. The Vesico was a very modern U-boat when it was introduced and it served the Finnish Navy well. Before World War II and also participating in the war, protecting Finnish waters and attacking Soviet ships. After the war it got decommissioned and placed in storage, until decades later it got restored and placed as a museum ship we see right here. So if you ever go to Helsinki, go to Suomenlinna as well, it will be worth it. Not just because of the submarine.